Hi, welcome to Eretec Solutions. Let's see the application, which is electronic notice board with predefined messages based on switches inputs. So this application, which requires some blocks. So I'm Cheshanan from Eretec Solutions. You can subscribe us from YouTube, the channel Eretec Solutions, also Facebook, the same Eretec Solutions page. So this application is very clear, which designed to display predefined messages which are saved already in memory from microcontrollers. But if you are expecting different messages, you can arrange some switches on your application. If you are operating particular switch, then it allows to print different messages on screen. I'll show you the block diagram of this application. So this contains three blocks. One is power supply unit and microcontroller and switches and LCD. Whereas power supply unit requires to convert AC to DC source. So this electronic devices requires DC power source as operating voltage, so that you need to convert AC sources into DC by using this power supply unit. Again, power supply unit contains the internal blocks as step down transformer, bridge rectifier, filter, regulator, all those individual components required to convert your AC source into DC source. And coming to this microcontroller here, I'm using Atmel 8051 microcontroller to do this simple application. It's an easy interfacing microcontroller, and most of the engineering students, they might have this 8051 in their academic part. So this controller, it is easy to work and most familiar microcontroller from academic. And whereas switches, I'm taking two terminal buttons. So one terminal of switches I'm connecting with IOs and other terminal I'm making ground. And this is my text screen, which supports only alphanumerics. There are different sizes of alphanumeric LCDs are available in market, like as 16x1, 16x2, 20x4, 32x2. So this represents number of characters per line and number of lines. If I am taking 16x2, which supports 16 characters per line with 2 lines, so that it allows to print 32 characters at a time. So now I am taking any size LCD as same, but it supports only alphanumeric. So if you are expecting any pictures and all, you have to go with graphical LCDs or TFT screens. That should be the different modules again. Now I'll show you the circuit of this application. So where I am connecting switches and where I am connecting my LCD physical lines. So here the buttons are connected across port 1, which is GPIOs from microcontroller. So there are 4 individual switches I am taking. If I am operating first button, I'll get proper message on screen. If I am operating second button, the screen will clear and it allows to print the new message. So whereas LCD connections are clear, whereas the first pin is ground pin and second pin is VCC, third pin is the contrast, and 4, 5, 6 pins. These are 3 control pins of LCD. So which needs to control as a programmer. Whereas RS pin, you have to change the logic of RS pin while giving commands or while giving text or data. If you are passing text to microcontroller, you have to make sure RS logic is 1, which means register select. So this control pin decides what you are sharing with LCD screen from microcontroller. If you are sending commands, and what is the need of these commands for LCD screens? LCDs follow some standard commands to fix the position of LCD and how many lines you are trying to use from this LCD screen, and moving cursor position from left to right or right to left, and all these different operations. If you are very good in commands, you can do scrolling operations, everything from these LCD screens. But all these commands are 1 byte size. If you are attempting to pass commands, So the same data lines you need to use, D0 to D7, which are 7 to 14 pins. If you are passing commands, make sure RS logic is 0. The same data lines used to send text also. But how LCD differentiates whether it is a command or data, that depends on RS control pin. If RS control pin logic is 1, it understands it is a text. If RS control pin logic is 0, it understands it is a command. Then what is the working of RW control pin here? So this RW logic decides if you are attempting for read or write. If you are looking to write, make sure RW logic is 0. If you are trying to read data from LCD screen to microcontroller, make it logic 1. And then enable. So this enable pin acts as a synchronization signal for your LCD screen. For every change of data, make sure or enable pin high to low ones. For every change of command or change of data, you have to make sure enable pin logic high to low ones with some time delay. And the remaining 7 to 14 pins which are used to transfer your commands or data. So this is the physical connection required between microcontroller and switches and LCD. Now I'll go through the source code of this application, so which is already developed in Keel IDE. The Keel Microvision IDE, which helps to develop source code for all microcontroller families. Most of the microcontroller families supports this Keel Microvision IDE. So generally IDEs are used to develop the source codes. Development means you need to text the code and compile the code and debug the code and create executable file for your source code. All these things you can do with the help of IDEs. Without IDEs, it is not possible to develop any executable file for your programs if from any language. Here I am using embedded C language to develop the source code for your microcontroller. The first header file is #include reg51.h, which supports to use all SFR registers. SFRs means from every microcontroller there is a list of SFRs for all different features. If you are working with GPIOs, there are standard names of IO ports, P0, P1, P2, P3, like this. If you are working with ADC, there is a ADC CON, ADC data, all this comes under SFR registers list. Which means any feature you are trying to use from microcontroller, you should know about these SFR registers from microcontrollers. Same way, 8051 also supports some list of SFRs based on features usage. From microcontroller, now I am using only GPIOs, which means IO ports. So those declarations I am doing with the help of S-bit standard data type. So this data type allows to declare one single bit from IO pins. Not only IO pins, you can declare with any SFR register, which is S bits, which is single bit from SFR register. But SFR register should be bit addressable. So the three hardware connections, whatever I did from hardware, these three I am declaring here. RS connected with P2.0, RW connected with P2.1, and enable is connected with P2.2. Whereas four switches connections I am declaring with port 1. First switch is connected with P1.0, second switch is connected with P1.1, third switch is connected with P1.2, and fourth switch is connected with P1.3. Now I am taking some user defined functions because LCD needs some commands and some data. There is a method to deal with this LCD screen. You cannot directly print characters just like that. You have to initialize your LCD screen with proper commands and then you can send your text, whatever you are expecting on screen. For that, I am taking those some user defined functions, LCD init and LCD display with argument type. See, I am declaring some functions without arguments and some functions with arguments. Empty parenthesis indicates that this function without arguments. And here I am taking string pointer with star s. And then I am taking one character argument function as data and character argument with command function. And delay, however, you need this delay function to make sure enable high to low. Main program starts from here. The first function I'm calling in main, which is LCD init. Just see the definition of this LCD init function. From this program, LCD init function, which allows to execute proper commands. These commands which requires to decide the cursor position, to move the cursor position from left to right, and activating all the crystals and fixing your cursor position first line first position. All these respective commands are required. You need to pass from microcontroller to LCD. See, every time if you are calling this LCD command with argument, the compilation goes to this command function. So whatever the argument you are passing from initialization function, which is given to this port 3. So here I am giving this argument value to port 3 because the data lines D0 to D7 which are connected across port 3 from hardware. While passing this command, you have to make sure RS logic is 0 and RW logic is 0 because you are doing write operation with LCD screen, and enable pin high to low. Every time if you are passing new command to LCD, make sure enable pin high to low once. So this LCD initialization function passes 5 commands for respective operations. After initialization function, come back to this main program. The text what I am expecting on screen, which is e notice board. This is my initial text I am expecting on screen. So that as my title of the program, while of one. This is an infinite loop. Once compilation enters into this while loop, which is keep on executing all these conditions or statements, whatever you written in this while loop. The first condition, as a user, if you are operating first switch from hardware, you have to clear the screen by using the standard command 0x01. So this command allows to clear the screen, and then whatever the message you are expecting on screen, you can pass it through this LCD disk. So you already declared this LCD disk function with string pointer. Just come to this LCD display function. So this display function maintains one string pointer. And within this function, again I am taking one temporary variable w, and I am taking for loop to execute these characters. You need to pass one by one to LCD because your LCD doesn't allow to take all the characters at a time. You need to send one by one, so that again I am using for loop here to pass each character through this LCD dat function. Just observe the condition here. The initial assignment with 0, anyway index starts with 0, and string always terminates with a null character. I'm just checking my condition with this string with a null character. Until unless the string reaches null character, this for loop will continue. And come back to this LCD dat function. So whatever the argument you are getting from this function, which is given to this dat function as argument. So this argument which is assigned with port 3. But one change from command function and data function here, RS logic is 1 because this is the data or text. While passing text, you have to take care of this control pin logic 1. While passing command, make sure RS logic is 0. That one difference you can observe here. While passing command, RS logic is 0. While passing text, make sure RS logic is 1. And RW remains 0 because still you are doing write operation with LCD. And enable pin high to low. For every change of character, make sure enable pin high to low. So this allows to do with this LCD display function combinedly with LCD dat function. So this I'm changing every time for second switch. If you are operating second switch, I'm changing my message on screen. I'm so busy. But before that, you have to clear the screen by using this suitable command 0x01. The same thing I am writing for third switch. I need to clear the screen before, and then you can display your own message on screen. Just you can change your text as per your convenience. Now and displaying my third message as I love my country. And the fourth message, I'm sleeping. So means for four individual switches, I'm displaying four individual messages which are already saved, so that this application comes under predefined messages. See, here I'm not taking any input from user. I'm just operating different switches. I'm getting different messages on screen. I'll show you this output with hardware simulation. So let's see this hardware simulation output, which is already designed. So for this, I'm using Proteus simulation tool. So I think this is one of the most popular simulation tool for all embedded engineers who are very familiar with this microcontroller families. So this Proteus simulation supports to execute your executable file, which is .hex file. You can link with this microcontroller and you can cross check your output. Now, with the file which is already linked, this program file option helps to link your hex file. So this is hex format .hex file you need to link, and then you can play your simulation. See, this is my text e notice board. As a user, if I'm operating first button, let's see the message, don't disturb. As a user, if I'm operating second switch, I'll get the another message, which is I'm so busy. As a user, if I'm operating third button, you can change your text on screen, I love my country. The fourth message on screen, I'm sleeping. So this allows to display different predefined messages on screen by using switches interfacing. So these kind of applications you can develop with basic microcontroller with simple interfacing concept. As a beginner, these videos will help you to learn 8051 microcontroller applications in a simple manner. Okay, so for more videos, you're continuously doing more applications with this microcontrollers for different families, not only 8051, we are working on PIC and ARM families and STM32 microcontrollers and Arduino families. We are working on all different microcontrollers. For more technical videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, which is Aerotech Solutions. Please subscribe us, please give your valuable feedback through comment, and please share and like. If anyone is looking for training from Aerotech Solutions, please contact with this number 9676327118. We are into different services, training, placement, development, projects and component sales also. So please get back for any requirement, any technical related things. You can feel free to contact with this number. And our physical address is, we are located at KPHB Hyderabad, which is near to metro station, and you can contact with this number 9676327118. And any queries, please email us ysnanda@aerotechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.